Unit 5. India. Population, Transport, Communication and Trade. The population of India as per 2011 census is 1,210.19 million. 1,021,193,422. It shows an increase of 19.31 crores from the population of 2001. India covers only 2.4% of the land area of the world, but is the home of about 17.5% of the world's population. There's a little more than one out of every 6% in the world is from India. In India, the first census was carried out in the year 1872, but the first complete and synchronous census was conducted in 1881, and the 2011 census represents the 15th census of India. Uttar Pradesh is the most populous state in the country with a population of 199.5 million followed by Maharashtra 112.3 million, Bihar 103.8 million, West Bengal 91.3 million and the combined Andhra Pradesh 84.6 million. Sikkim is the least populous state of India, 0.61 million. It is expressed as number of persons per unit area, usually per square kilometer. According to 2011, the average density of population of India is 382 persons per square kilometer. The most densely populated state of India is Bihar, and the state with the least population density is Arunachal Pradesh. Among the union territories, Delhi is the densely populated one with 11,297 per square kilometer, while Andaman and Nicobar Islands have the lowest density of population. High density, 500 to 1000 persons per square kilometer. Tamil Nadu, 555, Kerala, 859. Very high density, greater than 1000 persons per square kilometer. Puducherry, 2598. Delhi, 11,297. The year 1921 registered a negative growth rate of minus 0.31%, which happened only once throughout the demographic history of India and is called the year of great demographic divide. Only in the state of Kerala and the Union Territory of Puducherry, the sex ratio is greater than 1000. It is 1,084 in Kerala and 1,038 in Puducherry. The lowest sex ratio is recorded in the Union Territory of Daman and Diu, 618. The ratio between the economically active and economically inactive of population is termed as dependency ratio. The urban population of India had already crossed the 377 million in 2011, which is more than the total population of USA. By 2030, more than 50% of India's population is expected to live in urban areas. The following are the major problems of urbanization in India. Dr. Mahbub al-Haq defined as it is a process of enlarging the range of people's choice, increasing their opportunities for education, healthcare, income and empowerment. HDI classifications are based on HDI fixed cutoff points, which are derived from the quartiles of distributions of the component indicators. The HDI of less than 0.550 is used for low human development. 0.550 to 0.699 stands for medium human development. 0.700 to 0.799 for high human development. And 0.8 or greater for very high human development. Sher Shah Suri built the Shahi Royal Road to strengthen and consolidate his empire from the Indus Valley to the Sonar Valley in Bengal. This road from Kolkata to Peshawar was renamed as Grand Trunk GT road during the British period. At present, it extends from Amritsar to Kolkata. It is bifurcated into two segments. A. NH1 from Delhi to Amritsar and B. NH2 from Delhi to Kolkata. The total length of the national highways NHS in India is 1,11,000 km, which accounts for 1.8% of the total road network length. In 2016, the longest national highway is NH7, which runs from Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh to Kanyakumari in Tamil Nadu, covering a distance of 2,369 km, the shortest covering the national highway is NH47A, which runs from Ernakulam to Kochi Port, Wellington Island, covering a distance of 6 km. State highway runs through the length of 176,166 km as of 2016. The total length of the road of this category is 5,61,940 km, 16.81% in 2016. The total length of rural roads in India is 39,35,337 km as of 2016. National Highways Authority of India, NHAI, was established in 1995. It was an autonomous body under the Ministry of Surface Transport. They are constructed and maintained by Border Roads Organization. It was established in 1960 for the development of the roads of strategic importance in the northern and northeastern border areas. Golden Quadrilateral, 5,846 km long road of 4x6 lanes connecting India's four metropolitan cities, Delhi to Kolkata to Chennai, Mumbai, Delhi. This project was launched in 1999. Expressways: 1. Mumbai to Pune Road. 2. Kolkata to Dumdum Airport Road. 3. Durgapur to Kolkata Road. And 4. Yamuna Expressway between Delhi and Agra. Road density is the highest Kerala and lowest in Jammu Kashmir. The first train steamed off from Mumbai to Thane in 1853, covering a distance of 34 km in 1951. The systems were nationalized as one unit. The Indian Railways, the headquarters of Indian Railways is New Delhi. For operations and management, the Indian Railways is organized into 16 zones. 1. Northern India, Delhi. 2. Northwestern Railway, Jaipur. 3. North Central Railway, Allahabad. 4. North Eastern Railway, Gorakhpur. 5. North East Frontier Railway, Guwahati. 6. Eastern Railway, Kolkata. 7. East Coast Railway, Bhubaneswar. 8. East Central Railway, Hazipur. 9. West Central Railway, Jabalpur. 10. Central Railway, Mumbai, VT. 11. Western Railway, Mumbai, Churchgate. 12. Southern Railway, Chennai. 13. South Central Railway, Secunderabad. 14. South Eastern Railway, Kolkata. 15. South Western Railway, Hubal. And 16. Southeast Central Railway, Bilaspur. The Northern Railway accounts for the longest route length, followed by the Western Railway. The first suburban railway was started in 1925 in Mumbai. Chennai becomes the sixth Indian city with metro railway. Gatiman Express is the fastest operational train in India. This train connects New Delhi and Agra and touches 160 km per hour. This train takes a travel time of 105 minutes to cover 200 km journey. Konkan Railway. One of the important achievements of Indian Railways has been the construction of Konkan Railway in 1998. It connects Roha in Maharashtra to Mangaluru in Karnataka. And track measures 760 km. It is considered as an engineering marvel. There are 8 cities with metro rail connectivity in India. They are Kolkata, West Bengal, Chennai, Tamil Nadu, Delhi, Bengaluru, Karnataka, Gurgaon, Haryana, Mumbai, Maharashtra, Jaipur, Rajasthan, and Kochi, Kerala. The metro in Kolkata is the first one in India. It is also called as Mass Rapid Transit System, MRTS. As of September 2018, India has 507 km of operational metro lines and 381 stations. The state of Meghalaya has no railway network. It is a fuel-efficient and eco-friendly mode of transport. The water transport is of two types, inland waterways and ocean waterways, sea routes. The major ports on the east coast are Kolkata, including Haldia, Dock, Paradip, Visakhapatnam, Chennai, Ennore and Thoothukudi. The major ports on the west coast of Kandla, Mumbai, Nava Seva, Jawaharlal Nehru Port, New Mangalore, Marmagao and Kochi. Air transport in India made a beginning on 18th February 1918 when Henry Pickett carried a mail from Allahabad to Nainee in 1953. 8 different airlines which were in operation in the country were nationalized. Domestic airways fly within the boundaries of a country, and international airways connect major cities of the world. Indian Airlines provides the domestic air services and Air India provides international air services. Presently, there are 19 designated international airports available in the country. The first Indian postal stamp was issued in 1852 in Karachi. Collecting and delivering mail is the primary function in the Department of Post. It introduced the quick mail service in 1975 and today it covers the entire country. The quick mail service functions on the basis of the system of PIN, Postal Index Number, code which was introduced in 1972. In 2007, the Government of India merged the Air India and Indian Airlines under National Aviation Corporation of India Limited, NACIL, in which NACIL A provides international services, NACIL I provides domestic services and services to neighboring countries in Southeast Asia and Middle East. The INACT series, GSAT series, Kalpana 1, HAMSAT, EDU-SAT are the major communication satellite used for communication purpose. GSAT-7A is the recent launch, December 19, 2018, for communication programs. INSAT-1B, launched on 30th August 1983, is the first communication satellite in INSAT series. It helps to promote a balanced regional growth in the country, i.e. tree from Assam, coffee from Karnataka, rubber and spices from Kerala, minerals from Jharkhand, etc. are supplied to different parts of our country. The major imports are petroleum products, pearls, precious stones and semi-precious stones, gold and telecom instruments.